But the rest of the people in the AD line were waiting against the building and were not let in for maybe about 45 minutes. And then the rest of the general Hall H line was going in when I at a certain point, I felt like they had forgotten about the rest of the ADA line. And we were just standing there, and I have, you know, trouble just standing there for long periods of time. So I was just wondering why we weren't let in. And then once we got in, there was the red tops, the seats that put the red covers, they were taken. And so I was scrambling to find a space just to sit down, so it was filling up rather quickly. But they had made an announcement that apparently, you know, people sit in those seats either accidentally, by mistake, you know, whatever, but those seats were taken, and maybe that particular person was supposed to be there. But I was just trying to get a seat, and I just feel like maybe that could have been avoided right from the beginning if maybe the ADA line was moving more efficiently rather than not having that communication there between the people moving those lines that were responsible for moving those lines. So I just wanted to comment on that.
We did try something different with the ADA line this year in terms of wristbands, and hopefully that worked better for people that were using that service and wristbands in general for age. We do move the wheelchairs first because they are slower and have designated spots. And then we move in two chutes worth of general public, and then we should move the rest of the ambulatory. It sounds like we, for some reason, did not do that, and I'm sorry for that.